Hi friends, welcome back. Our today's topic is simplification. As we know, simplification is one of the very important topic for any kind of competitive exams, let it be bank, SSC, railway, UPSC, CSAT and placement trainings. In all the exams, minimum 2 to 3 questions will be there. And in bank and SSC, minimum 5 to 6 questions will be asked. And so simplification becomes a very important topic. Today we are going to see some multiplication trick. I have seen many times a student suffering in multiplication. So let's understand the trick to solve the multiplication in seconds. So our first question is 2.6 into 1.5 plus 3.4 into 1.2 minus 1.8 into 2.5 will be equal to what? So 2.6 into 1.5. If you are going to multiply by normal method, then it will take more time, right? And moreover, decimal is also there. So let's understand how can we multiply first. Now 2.6 into 1.5, right? Okay, you write 1.5 into 2.6 and then forget the decimal for some time. Just ignore if there is any decimal, right? So it will become what? 15 into 26. Now 15 into 26, how will you multiply? 15 into 20 plus 6. 15 into 20 will be 300 and 15 into 6 will be 90. So this will be 390. Now how many decimals we had? We had 2 decimals, right? 2 decimals, see, before 6, 1 decimal, before 5, 1 decimal. So from right side, after 2 numbers, you put 1 decimal. From the right side, after 2 numbers, you put a decimal. So it will become what? 3.9. Then again you see 3.4 into 1.2. This I can also write 12 into 34, decimal I have removed it for some time. Now 12 into 30 plus 4, so 12 into 30 will be 360 and 12 into 4 will be 48. This will be 8, 0 and 4. Now how many decimals? 2 decimals, and after 2 1 decimal, after 4 1 decimal. That means from right side after 2 numbers you have to put decimal. So this will become 4.08. And then again you see 1.8 into 2.5. So again remove the decimal, 18 into 25. Now 18 into 20 plus 5. 18 into 20 is 360 and 18 into 5 is 90. 0, 5, 4. This will be 450. Now how many decimals you had? 2 decimals after, sorry, before 5 1 decimal and before 8 1 decimal. So from right side, after 2 digits, after 2 numbers, you have to place 1 decimal, which will become 4.5, right? Okay, now you see 2.6 into 1.5 plus 3.4 into 1.2 minus 1.8 into 2.5. So this multiplication we have got here 3.9 plus, this is what, 4.08 minus 4.5. So first add these two and then subtract. So this will be 8, 9 and this will be 7 minus 4.5. Here you put 10. Now 8, 9 minus 5 is 4 and 7 minus 4 is 3. So 3.48, option 4 will be the correct answer for this question. So for solving this question, we don't have to do all those things. We can directly multiply here, 15 into 2 is 300 and plus 90. 390, 2 decimal means 3.9. So we can directly write here 3.9 and then 360 plus 48, 4.08 minus 18 into 2 is 36 plus 90, 4.5, and you will be directly getting the answer 3.48. So this trick will make you to solve the multiplication question in seconds. Let's see question number 2. Question number 2 has been already asked in SBI clerk exam. So how do we solve it fast? See here, 14 to the power 5 by 2 into 42 to the power 3 by 2 into 21 to the power 3 by 2, and in division it is 7 to the power x is equals to 432, right? Okay, now 14 to the power 5 by 2 into 42 to the power 3 by 2 into 21 to the power 3 by 2 is equals to 432 into 7 to the power x. See, basically what you have to do, you have to calculate 7 to the power x, right? Okay, so 7 to the power x you will be able to calculate only when the right side also there should be 7 to the power something. Then when the base is same, then the power will get equated and we will be able to get the value of x, right? Okay, if we have 7 to the power x, and here if you don't have 7 to the power something, suppose if you have like 4 2 4 3 1, which is not a multiple of 7. In that case, calculating the value of x will be very difficult. You'll have to take logs, and the log table will be not given in the exam. So basically what I want to say here is, if you have to calculate 7 to the power x, then you search only for 7 to the power something. So you see here, this is a factor of 2 into 7. Like 2 to the power 5 by 2 into 7 to the power 5 by 2 I can write. See, 2 into 7 will be 14, and 14 to the power 5 by 2, I had told you, a to the power x into b to the power x will be ab to the power x. So 14 to the power 5 by 2 I can write 2 to the power 5 by 2 into 7 to the power 5 by 2. So I have to take only 7 power. So 7 to the power 5 by 2, here you see 6 into 7 will be 42, so 7 to the power 3 by 2 I will take. Here again you see 3 into 7 to the power 3 by 2, so 7 to the power 3 by 2 I will take from here, and then 7 to the power x. The other things we will ignore, because if you want to calculate 7 to the power x, the remaining data also should be in the terms of 7 to the power x. Now you just add it. When the base is same, then the power will get added. If a to the power x into a to the power y into a to the power z, then a to the power x plus y plus z. See, this I have discussed in certs and indices. So please watch simplification video where I have discussed certs and indices. Now this will be 7 to the power 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2 is equals to 7 to the power x. Now you see, 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 3 is 11. So 7 to the power 11 by 2 is equals to 7 to the power x. When base is same, then we can equate the power. So the value of x will be equal to 11 by 2. So this question can be solved again in fractions of second. See, we can directly calculate. See, from here 7 to the power 5 by 2. So I will take 5 by 2 plus 7 to the power 3 by 2 plus 7 to the power 3 by 2. 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 3 is 11. 11 by 2 will be my answer. I hope you understood the question and the solution. Thanks for watching the video.